Dare to dream with me, my friends, about that settlement that gets so big, so mighty, so jam-packed full of people that you and me have got to take care of their needs. Whether that's sleep, whether that's food, whether that's entertainment, whether that's comfort, whatever it is, we're going to be looking after an army. Now, if you've been watching my Build It videos for a while, you'll know that we did a few little bedrooms. We did a small bedroom, and we did this wonderful little dormitory. Well, big dormitory over here for all of my army of settlers to speak and to sleep. And I've decided it's now time for us to do the other houses as well. Now, my Build It last week was about these roofs here, which uses... This one uses the warehouse roofs, but you can also do it with the barn roofs, and I think they look really good. And I've gone around all this end of sanctuary, and I've put together kind of these triangle based roofs, the barn and warehouse based roofs, and I think they look really, really good. You can even attach wall pieces and doors to them and things like that. That one's a mod, so ignore that one. But all the rest of them are coming along really well, and we're going to go through them one building at a time, decorating something different in each one. And this building over here is going to be our canteen. Dream with me, the place where these hungry men and women come after toiling in the fields and guard duty to eat communally. Big, big tables, eating all together, listening to their leaders, dreaming of tomorrow and feeling part of this glorious socialist community. So, decorations, furniture, stuff on the wall, stuff on the floor, useful mods that will help you out. All of these can be found in today's video. So ask yourself, can we build it? Can we eat it? Yes, we can. Welcome to Build It, ladies and gentlemen. My previous video talked about how to do these roofs, how to do the windows, how to do the floors, how to do the kind of internal walls, and I'm not going to be covering that at all again in this video now, because it's go and watch that video. Well, there's loads of other videos all around YouTube that kind of show how to do things like kind of roofs and stuff, but I would suggest you watch mine. But I'll just to show you how this building has ended up. You can see I've got some foundation floors down here. I've got the lighting in already. I've got kind of various coverings on the windows. All of the little holes in the walls have been kind of bandaged up with some sort of kind of wood or metal. I've even tried to use some variations here. I've got the boxcar doors. I quite happily use doors as decorations. I think they're pretty cool. I realize that gives us problems, but hey, let's just say that that's an openable window. And I thought this door here looked really kind of cool as a nice decoration as well. So just ignore the fact that these open and just admire them for the decorations they are. But as you can see, I've got floors in, the roof is in, the ceiling fans are in, the walls and windows are patched up. however you want to do them, so we're ready to start decorating. Now, I would recommend, before you start decorating, and this is what I do, is I walk around from room to room, and I kind of think, now, what is this place? And therefore, what goes in every room? Because some people like to build and to decorate by experimentation, and that's absolutely fine, but that's not my style. I kind of need to know the end point. I need to know where I'm going before I start. Otherwise, I spend ages kind of undoing the things that I've already kind of put together. So my decision on this one was, walking in the house, this is going to be the big communal canteen room. We're going to have a big table going down the middle here, all sorts of foodie decorations around the edge. This, shockingly, is going to be the bathroom. This is going to be the kitchen, so I'll have lots of ovens and things in there. This, I wasn't sure on this one, but this room, to be honest, I kind of thought could be an entertainment room, but I eventually kind of settled on an officer's mess, so slightly more senior people. So a second eating room, really. And this is going to be my wine cellar. I remodeled, by the way, because there's kind of a hole in the wall here, and you can walk through it. So you can actually kind of make that the door, or you could make this the door. And I decided, mainly for reasons of variety, just to kind of make this the door, you know, slightly kind of different variation on what we've got there already. So I'm going to try this one in a different way. I haven't filmed this way before. I've basically going to decorate the whole house here, and then I'm adding this video of me after the event, and then I'm going to speed the whole thing up. So it's going to go really, really fast, but you should be able to see exactly what I'm doing. Now, when you're decorating, the first thing you should probably do is think about where your mats go, because if you don't put mats and floor stuff down first, they're really hard to put there afterwards. And then I'm going to go for my big blocky bits of furniture, so tables and chairs and any kind of benches and things like that, because I want to kind of put the big objects in the room so I can start kind of feeling where the spaces are and where other objects can be. I personally really like objects to be a kind of little bit out of line with each other and, like, you know, at slight angles and things like that, but others of you will prefer them to be absolutely kind of regimented. And I am going to be using mods when I decorate this, but most of them will have alternatives that are already in the game. And I'm going to be using a mod I showed the other day that has a junk furniture. It's called Practical something or other. It was the last mod that I did, and it has some just junk furniture that's actually kind of made from junk. And I like to pretend that my settlers have been able to find some chairs, but not complete sets. And I like to use some of the broken ones as well and have that kind of haphazardly kind of look to it. But my officers, of course, get slightly better chairs, because where we found a dining room set, it'll go in, but we didn't find all four, so that can go in there like that. Now, there's a few key mods that I use for decorations, and I'll make sure I link them in the description, and I'll put my full mod list as well. One's by Elianora, who does loads of player houses. I've mentioned it loads of my streams, called it's the GTX Crafting 9000 or something like that, and it comes with this little mini kitchen. It comes with some shelves that are already decorated. I think this fridge is part of it as well, and basically what they are is they are objects like shelves that are already full of food or decorations and things like that, and just makes decorating so much quickly. However, if you haven't got those mods, or you're on a system where there are no mods, then you can just place objects manually into it, so you can recreate this. It'll just take you a lot longer to do so. I'm basically kind of doing this in layers, and I would suggest you kind of do the same kind of crafting idea in layers. So I'm going to go from room to room and just kind of putting those basic blocks in, and then because one of the things I find takes so long when you decorate is just literally going through the menu. So eventually I'm going to put posters on the wall, but I'm going to do all the posters at the same time, so I'm not kind of constantly going in and out of the menus. Now, another mod that I've talked about a lot is Do It Yourshelf, which is brilliant. And Do It Yourshelf basically is a special kind of shelf where you can stick decorations to it, specialized decorations to it. So what I'm doing now is I'm putting around about 10 special do-it-yourselves, and then we'll go back later and put specialized decorations items on them. I'm just going to, again, going around and making sure I kind of think, so that can be a shelf, that can be a shelf, because you don't want too many shelves either. You don't want to have everything being kind of cupboard, so I'm trying to get that, but that variety between things that are packed with objects and then other items like flowers on the floor or things like that. But as you can see, there's gonna be a lot of bookcases and shelves around here, because that's the predominantly, you know, this is a canteen, so it needs to be full of food. So it's good. This is going to have lots of kind of storage of food and bottles and things like that. Whereas another building might just have more kind of guns around the place, or by necessity have a bit more space. That lovely decoration I just put on the board there, you might want to pause and go and have a look back. Look, it's a shelf with some decorations and some kitchen utensils hanging around. That's also from the Crafting 9000 by Elianora. The descriptions. The link is in the description if you want to see it. And so now I'm just going back and I'm looking for kind of spaces and thinking other little places I can put kind of shelves, and it looks like we're done. Now, right there in the bathroom is a horrible little block on the floor. You can't get rid of it unless you use a mod which allows you to remove junk, not junk on the floor, but like a kind of a scrap all-time mod. So what I've done here is I've made a kind of little panel, little kind of raised surface, and I'm going to use the group select tool or glitch together with a concrete pillar, but it doesn't have to be concrete pillar to get that in. It didn't quite fit in because the door was in the way. So I just quickly turned on place everywhere, which I will use a couple of times in this video, but not because you can't do it otherwise, just for speed really. And I've got in here, and if you're not sure how the group select tool works and exactly what I'm doing there, I have a video which tells you all about it, so go and look at my channel. It goes into great detail about how it works. But what I've done is I've just made a little platform that goes above, firstly, the shower, and secondly, the other object that I couldn't get rid of, and it masks that. And it also, I think, looks really, really good, because this is not going to be, this is a diner, a canteen, so it doesn't need to have a shower and a bath, it needs toilets. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use that raised platform and put two toilets on, and I think the shower curtain actually works really nicely as a kind of divider, a cubicle divider. Now, you could also, the alternative way of doing it is to use one of those half pieces of wood, you know, in the wooden furniture, the half ones, you can actually kind of put slide that down the middle as well, which also divides it, but I'm fine with the curtain. And then I put some other little objects like sinks. The vault, the new Vault Tech DLC is the first one to finally give us toilets and sinks. I think the white toilets I'm using there are actually from a mod, but there are silver ones in the Vault Tech ones, which do the job equally well, as you can tell. And now it's time to for do it yourself. So now I'm going into the decoration side of the do it yourself bit. And I'm literally going to be stacking up the wine room with loads of bottles, and when I go into the kitchen and putting food down and so on. But if I can focus on the kind of the layers that I'm doing this, so I started with the rugs, then I went to the kind of the big objects, your tables, your chairs. I kind of worked out where the big things are going to be. I put my kind of shelving in. And the reason why I'm doing that is because sometimes you want to tweak and fiddle. And if you've put loads of decorations down and then you kind of think, oh, I wish that was 6 inches to the left, it can be a real pain in the ass. So I'm going layer by layer and layer, stacking it up. And that can sometimes mean that your room doesn't actually start to look well decorated until quite late on in the process. But now we're starting to go around and put all the objects on these shelves and decorate and things like that. It really starts, in my view, it really starts to come to life really well. In Do It Yourself, there are some full shelves and some half shelves, and I try and mix and match the two so it doesn't all look too uniform. So these are the little half ones you can see, and I'm just kind of, I think I've got some food on one side and some utensils and stuff on the other. And I'm just use your brain in terms of like what would be in a dining room and a canteen for all these kind of people. So obviously you need plates and cups and cutlery, and you need kind of food stacked in various places, what goes in a toilet, and don't forget just little decorations from time to time as well, like a vase or a picture or something like that. I think, again, I'm just kind of scanning there, looking for other things to kind of go in and try. And sometimes things can be slightly in the wrong room as well. You know, these are supposed to be kind of lived-in places, so don't beat yourself up too much if you kind of if in your mind, yeah, there could be a towel in the kitchen, you know, or something like that. It works nicely. So now it's time to put our signs on. Now I'm in with this particular playthrough. I haven't actually gone all the way through the Vault Tech DLC. I have with my other playthrough, but I haven't with this one. So I'm just putting the liquors sign here into the officer's mess. And but if you've gone all the way through the Vault Tech DLC, you'll know that you'll have the all the new vault posters, and they're brilliant for going around the place. You know, now wash your hands can go in the bathroom, and you know, work harder can go in the kitchen and so on. But if you don't have that, there's a really, really good mod called Law Friendly Posters, which basically puts tons of the, say, comic book covers back into the game as posters, which you can put up on the wall, and that they're brilliant for just covering the wall with things that with color and giving you kind of things to look at and stopping things being quite so bare. And again, that these are some of the posters I'm going through now and putting up on the wall. The coffee ones I've put up before, they all come from the Elianora mod again, the GTX 9000 one. I think she's a bit of a coffee addict, I think, because there's quite a few good quality coffee posters that go, coffee related posters that go brilliantly in cafes and canteens and hell, even in a kitchen, you know, for a player house or something like that, goes really, really nicely. So I'm just kind of scanning through and looking for anything kind of drink related or food related that will kind of fit in. And it's okay to kind of experiment and put something in there. And sometimes you can put something on the wall, go and decorate something else and come back. And if when you walk back into the room, you go, ugh, take it down. If you walk back into the room and you go, well, or even you don't notice it, then it's probably going to be fine. So now I've done my layers. I've done my mats. I've done my big objects. I've done filled my shelves. I'm now looking for kind of like tiny little bits to add on. So clocks on the wall. I think I put a food dispenser up there. Finding shelves that I've missed. Pot plants, which also comes from the Elianora mod, go really, really nicely to kind of just spark, to just brighten up a few little areas. I think I put a few more pot plants down there in a minute, actually. Another mod that I really like to use which is new, is Dino's Decorations, which is the same guy that made, same sorry, the same girl that made Do It Yourself, and they are clusters of objects that kind of go on anything. So rather than being like a big load of stuff on a shelf, it's just like, you know, a bunch of fruit that you can just shove on any surface you want. And what I'm going to do now is then go around and just fill lots of surfaces with that kind of junk. Again, if you don't have access to those mods, you can just put these objects manually, you know, go collect them in the wasteland and put them there. But I'm just kind of speeding up the process for myself, because ultimately, and unfortunately, it is the addition of items that make the the rooms feel alive. You know, when you go, when you walk around Fallout and you find the different kind of environments, you know you're in a kitchen because you've got the big furniture, which lets you know you're in a kitchen. But the bit that makes it feel alive and lived in is all the other objects that are currently kind of lying out there, and or things lying on their side. I mean, don't feel, sometimes just some don't feel bad sometimes if an object falls over. You know, you back away and kind of think, actually, is this all right? If you are deciding to place objects manually, then a good mod to use is OCD Decorator or OC Decorator, which stops them from kind of flying all over the place. Because obviously, if you can place objects and then they can kind of fall off if someone nudges them or dog meat kind of goes into them. But most of what I'm putting down here now comes from the Dino's Decorations mod, which gives us just putting a little cluster of books by the toilet here. But you can see that I think it took me about an hour to decorate this, maybe kind of like 45 minutes, and I think I've brought it down for you guys for about kind of 15. So I'm running it at about kind of 2.5 speed. So even with these mods, it takes a long time to kind of put this amount of decoration down. So if you're doing it manually, it'll take you even longer. But of course, you don't need to. I think one of the disadvantages of the mods I've used here is that sometimes things can look a bit over cluttered, like the shelves are a bit too full. But I'd rather have them too full than too empty. And then it's just goes putting a few plates around the place. Remember, plates and stuff can kind of go on the, think about it. When you've got a diner, you'll have you'll have things in storage, and then you'll have things that are currently being used, and try and get that balance between things which are over on the side waiting to be used by the next load of people that come out, but then also put a few plates on the tables themselves. And so here you can see I'm going around with a little noodle stack and putting together the kind of places where people maybe are about to sit or have just sat. Try and put them in front of the chairs themselves, obviously. One little thing I found is that chairs are actually quite hard to place objects on. I put a bench there and I couldn't get anything to kind of clip onto it, so I used Place Everywhere there to get it on, just to do it speedily. I believe I could have got, if I'd really wanted to, I could have got them on there by using the group select. If I'd gone out and connected them to a pillar or a piece of scaffolding, I could have brought it in and got it onto that surface, but it was hassle. Don't forget the floor. You'll notice I've put quite a few boxes of bottles on the floor, but I put some kind of spilled potatoes on there as well. I mean, if these rooms are supposed to be alive, then these are supposed to be lived in, then you will have things that are just kind of all over the place and haphazardly placed. Some people really like to remove the junk and the leaves and stuff that are in the houses, and I can see with the leaves, because people would sweep out the leaves, but I quite like the little bits of rock that have kind of fallen down, because I think for me it stops it being too beautiful. And so here's our final tour. If I bring you in, you can see our lovely little canteen. Our soldiers will be in soon to eat or to finish off what they've started. They've got a little booths there. This one, unfortunately, you can't really kind of put objects on it in quite the same way. So I left that one blank. Sneaky bit of graffiti here. Bit of a drink if necessary. Posters up. You can see all the decorations are here, and it creates a really nice environment for our characters to be in. Here's our cubicled toilet, complete with sinks and books and decorations and another water fountain, the ice machine there. I just stuck up another couple of shelves over there because that wall was pretty blank. But you can see the kind of effectiveness of the kitchen preparation area, with basically kind of food and bottles all over, ready to create things for hungry mouths. My officer's mess probably needs like some sort of flag or something to kind of make it feel a little bit more kind of military. You know, if this is supposed to be the where the officers go, we probably need to get some sort of Minuteman flag or something over there, which we can probably glitch in using some of the a pillar. But just for now, let's just stick that there to make it look a little bit more military. And last but not least, the wine cellar, where all the goodies are being stored, and I'm sure none of the soldiers would ever raid ever for some goodies in the middle of the night. So there you are. I hope you've enjoyed this little video. If you would have done anything differently, then do let me know. If you know of any other kind of mods or little techniques I could have done to improve this one that would have fit nicely here, then also, of course, please do let me know. And I hope you join me next time where we decorate one of our other three remaining buildings here, which would also be great. You have been fantastic. If you've liked it, then like it underneath. Do subscribe to the channel for mod its, build its, role plays, and all sorts of other cool stuff. And I will see you soon. Until then, happy munching.